The conference this year focused on the role of South-South cooperation and triangular cooperation in the implementation of Agenda 2030. In his opening remark, the SG pointed to four or five areas that he said should attract the focus of the actors involved in this South-South cooperation process.
I see five issues that will be central to implementing the Paris Agreement on climate change and achieving the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. And South-South cooperation can offer solutions to all of them.
These areas include climate change, it includes inequality, infrastructure and energy, gender, and also the repositioning of the multilateral cooperation system. As a continent, Africa contributed what was known as the Common African Position on South-South cooperation to the final outcome document. I'm happy to say that ECA provided strong technical cooperation and technical support in preparing that common African position, and several elements of the propositions that we suggested during the preparation of the document ended up in the outcome document of the conference. As far as ECA is concerned, in terms of a regional commission, we think that our work, whether it be in support of the CFTA, regional integration, or in support of the resource mobilization and planning processes of African nations, building partnerships, etc., already incorporate and reflect the spirit of South-South cooperation, meaning that in the outcome document, it was clearly stated that regional commissions, UN regional commissions, play a key role in advancing and promoting South-South cooperation. Which brings me to say some of the key issues that were highlighted during the conference. One is how to set up a better institutional framework, okay? Particularly since we are now talking about implementing Agenda 2030 in its 17 goals. It is very important that the institutional framework of South-South cooperation and triangular cooperation be one that reflects the aspirations of Agenda 2030 of leaving no one behind. Notice that when I say triangular cooperation, it means that the process involves not just the countries in the South, quote-unquote, meaning developing countries, but also the other actors, partners to developing countries, meaning Europe, America, and other areas of the world that have an interest in advancing development both in Africa and in the South in general. So the call here is for all these actors to strengthen the technical cooperation, to strengthen the capacity of the developing countries, to strengthen the institutions in the countries in a way that is nationally led. So it has to be country-led as well. That those things should happen in a way to strengthen the capacity to implement and reach the goals of Agenda 2030.